of the movement, of the feeling of it, is very important. That's what helps to guide the Shen, guide the mental meditative imaging, so that we can really relax, feel it, and not be too robotic or thinking, or it's just, when we feel too robotic, go back towards the image. Forget the mechanic, go into the image, feel it for a while, and then the mechanic will start to fix itself as well. The concept of Qigong is to unite the Jing, the Qi, and the Shen in one single exercise. The expression of the Jing, as we're doing the movement, represents itself through the structure, through the bone structure, through how the ligament, everything that's more material within the body, express itself, move, and function. The Qi is associated with the breathing at first, but eventually will dissociate and won't need to have this direct connection with the breath. But at first, the breathing is a little bit like the, how's it called, the bellow, to blow the air on the fire to make it stronger. The Qi is the fire. So once we're able to really have a strong fire, a strong Qi, then we can forget the breathing or have a very different breathing, even if the Qi moves very quickly through the body as we do other stuff. And then the Shen, we use the image at first to help us reconnect to it, and then gradually we can let the image fade out and go into the state of tranquility and just observe how the Qi circulates through the body. Within these three elements together, depending on our own personality, one of the three might be easier for us to grasp. Some people who are very athletic naturally will understand a little bit more how the connection of the structure makes the body feel stronger, and then they'll focus a bit more on that until the Qi and the Shen adapt themselves and help strengthen. Other exercises will focus a lot on the breathing, and through the breathing, in order to breathe properly, then the structure will start to align itself better. And then the feeling of Qi can develop, you can use the Shen using an image that help us, you know, if I'm turning the body to look at the moon and my body is a little bit closed, if I think about the moon, if I think about reaching to grab it, then it will change my body. It will change my position. So my mind will affect the way my body is expressing itself because I use the right image. Now here, if I use the image of I want to feel strong, feeling the internal strength expressing itself and pushing, then I can't have that image and be like this. You know, I can't have internal strength and have a weak structure. If I want to feel that strength, I follow it and I let it express itself. The connection, that the feeling that the back is extremely strong, that I can push onto something very easily without creating any muscle tension, just by adjusting the connection within the body, or just by thinking, up, I want to have feel strong, then woof, the body adjusts itself. So all three of these can be used, with one being the focus rather than the other two, to help people find the way that's good for them. And once we have it, the other two will start to develop accordingly as well, and eventually we can play and switch between the three. That's why when I first explained to you the movement, I explained a little bit some of the structure, then I explained to you a little bit with the image, and then I explained also with the breathing. If we follow the breathing, it gives us that rhythm, and we find how to harmonize everything together. Because the Qi is the link between the Jing and the Shen. I can have a very good open mind meditative quiet, but if I'm always seated and a little bit not in a good position, then the body is not nourished. I can have a very good athletic ability and doing a lot of sports, but if I'm always worried, thinking about stuff, or, you know, not really focusing on what's going on, then my body is good, but my mind is always very busy. Whereas if I bring them together and use the breath and the Qi to combine them, then all of a sudden everything just becomes that much more powerful, and a lot of athletes actually talks about it or live that a few times during a career, where they have that very quiet moment where they feel that everything is connected and they make the best play of their life. And sometimes they can spend many years trying to find that feeling again without ever getting back into it. So through Qigong, that's what we're trying to develop. That idea of meditation, relaxedness, feeling, proper body structure, and then the Qi just flow and fills up everything. And once the Qi is developed enough, we can just use it and follow it to create and adjust the structure and help the mind be present. And it's something physical. It's our body. That's how it works. So when we combine them together, it just gives us the full potential of the capacity of our body, the full potential of being human.